Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about some coding questions and we will try to see how that particular code is working. So we already know that the scope of var and let is different. Let has a block level scope, var keyword has a function level scope. So this is the first question, and what do you expect as an output? So you can see what we are doing is, this is a empty object we have. First let me clear this out so we can also see the output. So here we are passing in an object and the console.log a, this is the ify block. I'm passing the same object here and I'm trying to set the value a.a and a is set to null. So here we are passing this object which is available here, right? Whatever you are setting null, that doesn't, so this is a, this is not, this is the pass by value, right? So if you just try to print this value, then you will get a here, a10. And why that is happening is, we got this object and we are passing that in the ify block, right? Now you can change the reference, you can change the properties. You cannot just set it null and a will get impacted here and a will also become null. Now another simple set of questions is about prototype. So here we have function person, okay, and if the, you are passing the name, then I'm setting the name property in the options, and there is a prototype also where I'm setting the options name is a default name. So whenever you are calling these constructors foo and bar, what I'm doing is we are setting the options dot name property, okay. Now if you try to access this in this console.log foo.options.name and foo.options.name. Now you see that same property exists in the prototype also, and prototype is like a common reference for all the objects which you are creating. Foo, bar, whatever the objects you create, they will share the same prototype. If you are just changing the property of the prototype name property with the foo and bar, then the last value will persist and we will get, you can say foo in both the cases. So let me just comment this out, or we can execute this also. So you can see we are getting bar, whatever the value we have set in the last. Okay, similarly, some common set of examples is about scope. Again, this questions I have. So object I have, and then I'm passing that into the ify block. Okay, what it is doing is, it is just, in this object, I'm not doing anything special, right? In the ify block, I'm passing this object. Object has a a1. And I'm not changing the property a1 to something else. It's just setting, okay, object is this. But that is in the ify block. It will not override anything which is declared outside. So here object.a will be 1 only. Okay, so these are some tricky questions you can say, which we can think about. And one more is like about this object. There are many like this. So this is an object. We have a get price. We created an object using object.create and then we are setting the price value. That is fine. Delete custom object.price. We are deleting the price property from here and then we are doing get price. So this is a little tricky. Custom object.getPrice, it will try to print this dot price value, right? So this dot get price, what output we are expecting here? So this question, in this we have one object, right, and we are actually creating the object out of it and then we are deleting the property. So get price should point to this dot price, which is 20.99. so we actually created a new object, custom object dot price. You are actually trying to change the property to 19, so it's a copy of this, so you are just changing it in the custom object. Now if you just try to see this more, console.log, if you try to print what custom object currently having and what my object is having, there you will get the answer. And try to run this. So custom object right now pointing to this price, and your my object is still holding the same value. It has a price 20 and it is having the same function. Now what we are doing is, we are deleting the custom object dot price. Okay, so you have actually removed this price property from there. And now if I try to do this console.log custom object, instead of printing it here, if I print this here, then custom object will have only function. The price is now gone. Custom object dot price value is now gone. So now if you try to do the get price, custom object dot get price, it will actually check in the proto. Okay, do you have this price property? Custom object price you have deleted, so you don't have. So it will go to the my object and will try to fetch the price property from there, and that is 20.99 while you call this get price method. Okay, so this is how this is working. I mean, it's a proto chain. I created this copy of this object. Now we can actually do this in multiple steps. Console.log. This is my first console.log for custom object. Okay, here I am inheriting all the properties. Now, actually I did override. So I will try to print it here. And now I have deleted this property and I'm printing it. So now let's see the difference here. So initially the price, you can see custom object dot price 19.9, because this get price another property is in the proto, that is still there. This is a new object you have created. This new object has both the property price and get price, but that is in the proto. When you try to do console.log custom object, you can't see that, but that is in the proto if you try to access it. And you can also call this custom object dot get price, you will get that. So initially the price was empty, price was having 19. Once you assign it, initially it was empty. So indirectly like this, now users have set the price property. So this is his own property. You have set own property to this object. It also has the same property in the proto, I mean the parent object from which you have inherited. Here you actually deleted this, so it become empty again. Now you are trying to access this again. So obviously it will access it from the parent, which is 20.99. I mean, these questions are simple one, but trickier one. They will get your understanding about object.create, object.assign, spread operator and all. Object.create is actually inheriting the existing properties and putting that in the new object. So if you try to do custom object dot has own property price, it will be false because it's not his own property. But you can override and you can define, okay, now it has its own property price also. Okay, now we can talk about one more thing, which is about how we deal with objects in JavaScript. Scope, okay, let's talk about scope also because we haven't discussed about it. So we are creating the variables using either let and var. And let has a block level scope and var keyword as a function level scope. And that you can understand from these simple examples how this scope is working. So this is simple functions. I put a printed. So if you just try to print the value of printed here outside, you still have the value, right? Even so, test function you are calling, right? And you are iterating onto this loop and printed is getting some value assigned. So this printed value is available even outside the scope because the var keyword has a function level scope. Okay, same thing if you try to do with the let keyword and all, then you will get a different answer. So if you just try to see this. Now, if you just change this existing code to a little bit, let me just clean this up. Now, if you try to, so here I know that printed value is there, but if you try to access the sum variable outside, then obviously you should get an error because sum variable is available inside this scope, right? Sum variable is not defined in this particular, right? And you will get an error. So if you just try to remove this and you can just try to print some variable here, then that should be fine because in the functional scope, I have that value. Okay, 9 and I'm available. This is what we are getting. So we are good here. Now on the similar thing, if I just try to convert that to a block level scope by just using the let keyword instead of var keyword. Okay, here I have it printed. Now if you try to print it here, because let is block level scope, let printed value is defined inside a block, it doesn't have anything to do outside this block, so you will get error directly, reference error, that printed is not defined. So this is the basic difference between the block level scope and a functional scope. This is also fine, like you can create a let and const, both are providing a block level scope. So instead of let, you can also use const. The only difference is const you can't override. Just a basic question. Okay, now we'll talk about how we are iterating onto the object, right? So there are many ways in which we are iterating onto the object, and there are new collections also there, like we have a map, set. Earlier we were having only object and array to store the values. Object is storing in the key value format, array is using indexes to store that value. Now what we can do is we will just try to understand the object and array, because there may be a questions around how we are iterating onto the object, what all different possible ways is there, like object.keys, you can get the keys and then you can just run a for loop, you can directly run on an object. For of loop you generally run on an array. Okay, so let's talk about these new data types, which is set and map. Okay, so till now, if I just talk about a simple object here, const obj, and it has some properties, right? So how can I iterate onto this properties? Getting the property length and all, objects are not iterable in first sense, but still there is a method for in loop. Or you can do object.keys, you will get the keys, and that is nothing but an array, and you can just loop around it, the loop on that array, right? So objects were not designed to be used as a collection. As a result, there is no efficient way to determine how many property object has. You can still do object.keys and then do the length. When you loop over an object properties, you also get the prototype properties. And there is no proper way that whatever the way you inserted the properties in an object, while you iterate, you will get the same order. There is no guarantee. You can just check if object has the property, object.hasOn property. And while doing a for in loop, you might have done this for in loop for let I in obj. It will iterate only those properties which exist in the object itself, like object.hasOn property. So for in loop is just like a workaround. When you loop over an object property, the property won't necessarily be retrieved in the same way they were inserted. Okay. So what you do is currently object.keys, we get all the keys from this object, and we can actually do a for of loop, and then we can actually do a console.log, I think, log obj of key, which is I, right? Or for in loop, you get all the property. Okay, so there may be a question something like this on the object. What happens when you do object.create null? It's like a simple bare object which is not inheriting anything. When you try to do this object.proto, it will point to null. Okay, because it's like a bare object which is not inheriting object.prototype. Okay. And the other tricky part of iterating onto object, you can actually use object.keys, you can run for in loop and all these things. Object.keys is slow because what it is doing, it is also getting the prototype properties of each and every property in the object. Okay, similarly, we have array, right? Array, you can actually use for of loop. Simple, like we have for of loop. So first of all, what is the difference between array and object? Both are type of object. Array also has the indexes. So if you just try to talk about objects, this is an array, right? This is also an object and you can actually get the indexes. This is zeroth index 1, so 0 is the key, 1 is the key, 2 is the key, and the values are 1, 2, 3. So you can also run the all the kind of operations, like you can access this using key also. Object dot, so this is an array. Simply what you do is you run for a loop onto an array. But what if you want to access it using for in loop? Let's try this. Let I in obj console.log I. So you are getting the values, right? I here is the index. So if you try to get the actual value from this array, you can do something like this, and here you will get the actual values. So for in loop is for object, and array is also an object. You can just simply do a for of loop if you try to get the values of it. Console.log I. For of loop can be used on the iterable objects and you will get the values, right? So there is a difference between for in and for of loop. For in loop only works only on those properties which has on property true for that object. I mean, those properties are defined in the object itself. It will not iterate on the inherited properties. Okay, that's it guys. Thanks.